गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर एबल टू हियर मी राइट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल। सी इन यस्टरडेज एग्जांपल ओनली थिंग इज we should have not squared it. You can directly proceed with A and then you will get the answer. If needed, I'll do it at the end of the session. We'll start fresh with 38. Okay. So prove that the radius of the right circular cylinder of greatest curved surface area, which can be inscribed in a given cone, is half of that of cone. So there is a cone. So the cone is given. In this, you are trying to inscribe a right circular cylinder, and this cylinder should have the greatest curved surface area. Okay. If that is going to be the case, let's say this radius is R and this radius is capital R, then we need to prove that small r is equal to capital R divided by. Small r is equal to capital R divided by So here, how to collect the data is, listen to this carefully. Prove that the radius of the right circular cylinder of greatest curved surface area. No. So here, when they say given cone, means the volume of the cone is given. Okay, because cone is three dimension, and for three dimension, you are going to define the volume only. So the volume of the cone is basically given. So volume is how much? 1/3 pi r² into capital H. Okay, volume is 1/3 pi r² capital H. So let this be equation number one. So let's say the height of the cylinder is small h. Okay, and here the radius is small r. Can I say if this angle is theta, this angle will also be theta? Then what is tan theta from the bigger triangle? Tan theta is equal to capital H by R. Then tan theta from smaller triangle will be capital H minus small h divided by R. Accepted, guys? Right. So capital H by R is equal to capital H minus small h divided by R. Now what we can do is, so they're asking prove that the radius of the right circular cylinder of greatest curved surface area. What is the curved surface area of the cylinder? What is the curved surface area of a cylinder? Is it not 2 pi r into h?
Yes, sir.
So it is 2 pi r into h. So if I call area as 2 pi r h, this is what we need to differentiate. But what can we do? One minute, guys, one minute. When they say of given cone, R is a constant and H is also a constant, right? So since they have told given cone, R is equal to constant and H is also constant. Okay, so 2 pi R H. Now what can I write in the place of small r? So observe, in the place of small r, can I write capital H minus small h into capital R divided by capital H? Right, when that is the case, area will be equal to 2 pi into capital H minus small h divided by capital H into R into small h. Now, area is a function of how many variables?
What is that one variable?
It is H. Right. So,
yes.
Area, can I write it as 2 pi R divided by H into small h into capital H minus H square? Okay. So, dA divided by dH is how much? 2 pi R by H into capital H minus 2H is equal to 0. From this, what can I conclude, guys? Small h is equal to capital H by 2. Let me call this as equation number 1. So, please write it down till this step. Are you guys able to understand what I am doing?
Yes, sir.
Good. So let me call this as star. Okay. So d square a by dh square is how much? 2 pi r divided by h into 0 minus 2. It is a negative value. So at h is equal to capital H by 2, area is maximum. When small h is equal to capital H by 2, R will be how much, guys? Capital H by 2 into R divided by capital H. This and this will get cancelled. Small r will be equal to capital R divided by 2. Okay, that is what they asked us to prove. Hence, prove. Okay, so this is how the problems will be. Second, shall I move on?
Yes, sir.
Find the absolute maximum and minimum values of a function given by this function in the interval 1 to 5. So f of x is equal to 2x cube minus 15x square plus 36x plus 1 on the interval 1 to 5. So what is f dash of x? 6x square minus 30x plus 36. So if I equate this to 0, 6 into x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So x minus 3 into x minus 2 is 0. So x will be 3 or 2. So 3 and 2 both belong to 1 to 5. So f double dash of x is how much? On differentiating this, we'll get 12x minus 30 . So what are the this is greater than 0, this is less than 0, this is the point of minimum and this is the point of maximum. So but they asked values, no?
So what is f of 3, guys? Find f of 3 and let me know.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what about f of 2, da? This example number 29, but it seems something else, huh? 56 has come. Oh, correct. Sorry. Listen, I made a yes. So these are there, no? So f of 3 and f of 2, you found the values. But listen, since the function is included at 1 and 5 also, since the function is included at 1 and 5, find f of 1 also. What is f of 1?
Yes, sir.
And f of 5 is?
56.
Yes. So out of all these values, which is the least value? F of 1 is the least value. So this is the local maximum value. And this will be the minimum value. So what we are trying to see in these kind of problems, no? Whenever you have the domain, having the endpoints included, apart from finding the points in between those endpoints, you should take the function value at the endpoints also. And then check which one is the least and which one is the maximum. So the minimum value, maximum value, oh, sorry. Oh. This is minimum value. And this is the maximum value.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Please tell.
Why did we find maximum and minimum earlier? Like f double why dash did
we, of x. Why did we
find that maximum and minimum earlier? 6 and minus 6.
Because
they asked only in 1 to 5.
Now 1 to 5 only, but what has happened is 3 and 2 are also points between 1 and 5. No? So I was interested to find among 3 and 2, at which value is the function value maximum? So that's what we got. No, f double dash of 3 is coming out to be greater than 0. It is giving minimum value. That is why f of 3 is 28 and f of 2 is 29.
It's compulsory to find like that, sir.
It is better to do. I'm not saying it is compulsory, but it is better to do. That depends on how the answer key is designed. When you have a standard steps, no, it's better if we follow that.
Okay, sir.
I'm just saying, let's not take chance. I'm not saying it is compulsory, because if you find the function values itself, you will get the answer. But suppose in the answer key, they have given the instruction to the examiner saying the double derivative test is also needed. That time you might lose half mark. Why to waste it when you know the concept?
Okay, sir. I understand.
Yeah. Find absolute maximum and minimum values of a function given by this thing. I want you guys to try it up. Please. problems. I've done many problems. You try and let me know. I want everybody to try.
Tell me. You can just directly find f of minus 1 and f of 1, right, for this?
Yeah, you have to find it because they are included, no? There
you need to minimum is minus 18 and maximum is 6.
Minimum is minus 18. Minus 9 by 4, something you're saying. Can you check it again? Anybody else who got the answer?
No, sir.
No.
Not yet, sir. I'm doing it, sir.
F dash of x is how much, sir? 12 into 4 by
16x, 1 by 3 minus 2x power minus 2 by 3.
This 4, 16x power 1 by 3 minus 2x power minus 2 by 3. If you equate it to 0, 8x power 1 by 3 is equal to x power minus 2 by 3. If this comes this side, x will be equal to 1 by 8. Did you get x is equal to 1 by 8?
No, sir, I didn't get x equal to 1 by 8.
Sir, I got 1 by 2.
So what is f of 1 by 8? 12 into 1 by 8 to the power of 4 by 3 minus 6 into 1 by 8 power 1 by 3. How much is it? 12 into 1 by 2 the whole power 4, that is 1 by 16 minus 6 into 1 by 2. This will cancel 3 times, 3 times, 4 times. So f of minus 1 is? F of minus 1 is 12 minus of minus 6. That is 12 plus 6, 18. F of 1 is? Minus 6, 6. So the least value is minus 9 by 4 and the greatest value is 18.
Sir, how is it positive 12, sir?
How is it positive?
Well, like for f of minus 1, shouldn't it be minus 12 minus 6?
Minus 12 minus 6, sir. Okay, listen. That is why you got minus 18, huh?
Yes, sir.
So 12 into minus 1 power, is it not power 4, the whole power 1 by 3?
Okay.
So minus 1 power 4 is positive. So that is why it is.
I made a mistake. Understood.
Yeah, I understood. I understood why you got 18, minus 18. So be careful. It is minus 9 by 4, comma 18. Minus 9 by 4 is the least value. 18 is the maximum value. So there is a helicopter of enemy which is flying along the curve given by the curve y is equal to x square plus 7. A soldier placed at 3 comma 7 wants to shoot down the helicopter when it is nearest to him. Find the nearest distance. So the enemy flight is flying in this way, parabolic path, which is given by the equation y is equal to x square plus 7. So there is a point 3 comma 7 from where a soldier wants to shoot down the helicopter when it is nearest to him. Find the nearest distance. Let's say 3 comma 7 is here. From 3 comma 7, let's take the point on this as x comma x square plus 7. Okay. So what is the distance term? What is the distance between those two points? Root of x minus 3 the whole square plus x square plus 7 minus 7 the whole square. So root of x minus 3 the whole square plus x power 4 is d. Okay, I'll call it as small d. Now, capital D will be equal to d square. So x minus 3 the whole square plus x power 4. Right. So derivative of capital D with respect to x is 0. 2 into x minus 3 plus 4x cube is equal to 0. Now solve for the value of x and tell me. You should actually get 3 values of x.
Sir, can you scroll up?
So find out the value of x and tell me, guys.
I got x equal to 0, x equal to minus 1 and x equal to plus 1.
X equal to 0 will not come down. Because the equation has a constant. X equal to 0 will not satisfy.
Okay.
Okay. This one, let me explain. Not sure if you guys know this. Whenever you have a cubic equation, right? The first root alone, you should use trial and error basis. Okay. So when you put x is equal to 0, what you get? It will not satisfy. Then you can try x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 is satisfying. 2 plus 1 minus 3. Yes, it is giving us 0. So x is equal to 1 is possible. Then there is something called as, I want everybody to make a note of it. There is something called as synthetic division method. Have you heard of this?
Yes, sir.
Right. So what does the synthetic division method say? You should put an L-shaped box like this. Write the coefficient of x cube here, coefficient of x square, coefficient of x, and the constant. Okay. Write the root which you got from the trial and error basis. Okay. Below the first number, always put a zero and multiply the root with zero. You will get, add the value zero. 2 plus 0 is going to give you 2. Multiply the root with 2. So what will you get here? You will get a 2 here. So add them. Okay. Unlike the normal division where you subtract, here you keep adding 2. Okay. Again, 1 into 2 will be 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 into 1, 3. Add them. You will get 0. Let me know if it is clear till this step.
Clear, sir.
Okay. So this 2x cube plus x minus 3 can be written as x is equal to 1, right? Then x minus 1 will be 0. X minus 1 into 2, put an x square, put an x and a constant. So 2x square plus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x minus 1 into 2x square plus 2x plus 3 is nothing but 2x square plus x minus 3. So what we basically did is we factorized it into two factors where one of the factors will be linear and the other will be a second degree, other will be a quadratic. Right. So what will be the root, guys? X is equal to 1 is a root. And what will you get when you factorize this? 2x square plus 2x plus 3. 6 is there, no? So when you factorize 6, what are you going to get? 1 and 6. I don't think any real root is possible, right?
Yes, sir.
So the only option is x is equal to 1. So this will never be 0. This will go to the other side. So x is equal to 1 is the only point. When x is 1, what is the value of y? Y is 8. So the distance between the points will be 3, 7 and 1 by 1, 8 will be how much? Square root of 4 plus
5, sir.
1. It is square root of 5.
Root 5.
Is that the answer? Yes. So root 5 is the minimum distance that is possible. Is everyone clear with what I did?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now it is your turn. I want everybody to do it on your own. Make it fast. Every problem, 2 minutes time. Make it fast. Find the maximum minimum values if any of the following functions of if any of the following functions given by f of x is equal to 2x minus 1 the whole square plus 3. Do it fast.
How much is the answer?
We'll get 57 by 60.
So. 57 by 16, correct? And this is the least value. Because the double derivative test is greater than 0. Correct? I hope everybody got it.
Yes, sir. So maximum value, we should just leave it, sir.
Maximum value is infinity. Maximum value is infinite.
Should we specify that, sir?
No need actually, but it's better you write it fine. Because it's an upward parabola.
Okay, sir.
It's better you write it now. Try for this.
Getting minus 2 as the minimum value.
Minus 2 by 3.
And minus 2 is the minimum value.
So f of minus 2 by 3 is how much?
Minus 2, sir.
Or is that minimum value or maximum value?
Minimum value.
That's right. That should be the minimum value. And maximum value will be infinity. Okay. Try for this one, you will get maximum value at a particular point.
Thirty-nine by four,
and that is the maximum value, right? You will get it as maximum value, and the minimum value is minus infinity, because this is a downward parabola. Okay. So all these things you can try them later. All these parts I'm leaving it to you for you to try. We'll do some statement problems alone. Find two numbers whose sum is 24 and whose product is as large as possible. So let the two numbers be what? X and Y. Such that x plus y is how much?
24.
And xy should be maximum. This xy, let me call it as product, and let me call this as sum. So product is a function of two variables. So product can be written as x into 24 minus x. That is nothing but 24x minus x square. So derivative of product with respect to x is 24 minus 2x. Equated to 0, x will be equal to 12. So do the second derivative test. You will get minus 2, which is less than 0. So you will get a maximum value at x is equal to 12. When x is 12, y will also be 12. So the value of x and y will be 12 comma 12, so that the product is as large as possible. That is, it is having a maximum value. Next, do this problem. They have told find the two positive numbers. Have that in your mind. What is the answer, guys?
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Tell me.
We have to always like get an equation from the sum and substitute in the product, sir.
Yeah, because sum is given. You should always get the value from given and substitute it in the value which is supposed to be maximum or minimum. The vice versa is not right.
Okay, sir.
So x will be equal, y will be equal to 60 minus x. Okay, 60 minus x is a big number, right? So do one thing. X is equal to 60 minus y, substitute that and then solve. Make it a function of y and then solve and let me know.
Sir, is it 30 and 30? Sir?
Is it?
30, x is equal to 30, y is equal to 30.
X equal to 30, yeah? X equal to 30, y is equal to 30. I don't know. Anyone else got it? So, y, x is equal to 60 minus y. Others, what is the answer? Is it right?
But 45 equal to y square.
Let me try. 180 y square minus 4 y cube is equal to 0. So 2 y square into 9 minus 2 y is equal to 0. So y is 9 by 2.
Be 180 y square, sir.
Then it will be 45, no? Y is 45, x is 15. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This one is similar. You can do it as homework. Homework. Let's do this. Show that all the rectangles inscribed in a given fixed circle, the square has the maximum area. Means you have a circle inside which there is a rectangle inscribed. Right. We need to prove that the rectangle can have a maximum area if it is a square. Means we need to prove that the length is equal to breadth. So here, what is there? Given fixed circle means the radius of the circle is fixed. So R is fixed, means it is not a variable. But L and B are variables, right? So area of rectangle is what? L into B. But what is the relation between L and B here? L by 2, this will be B by 2. So R square is equal to L square by 4 plus B square by 4. Correct?
Yes,
so B will be equal to root of 4R square minus L square. Take this and substitute it here. L into, in the place of B, it will be root of 4R square minus L square. So this is the area of the rectangle. So derivative of area with respect to length is how much? Do this and tell me fast.
So I got root over 4 r square minus x square plus half into 1 by root of 4 r square plus l square into L.
How much, sir? L into 1 by 2 root of 4 r square minus l square into minus 2L plus root of 4 r square minus l square is equal to 0. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Minus L square is equal to 4 R square minus L square under a root. Sorry, not under a root. The square root will go off. I'm getting R is equal to 0.
Sir, how did minus 2L come, sir, numerator? The left.
Because derivative of minus L square.
Okay, sir. Understood.
Then it will be plus here. Sorry. Then you will have 2L square is equal to 4R square, which implies L is equal to root 2 R. When L is equal to root 2 R, you can check that B will also come out to be root 2 R. Since L is equal to B, the rectangle is supposed to be a square. Right. Since the length of the rectangle is... Please tell me.
In the above equation, sir, we didn't get 4R square by dl because R is fixed, right? It's a constant here.
Yeah, because that's right. Because R is constant, no? They have told... So, they have told given fixed circle means R is constant. That is what you need to take. R is constant, area of the circle is constant, all those parameters are constant.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. So, try this. Why are others not even trying? Are they guys doing it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
Could you do the sum, sir?
Not getting. Show that the right circular cylinder of given surface means there is a right circular cylinder, okay, which has a radius r and the height as h. Okay, show that the right circular cylinder of given surface. So surface is equal to 2 pi r h. Okay, and maximum volume is such that the height is equal to the diameter of the base of given surface. So when they say
surface
shouldn't be 2 pi r s plus pi r square. Sir.
Yes, because you need to take the total surface area. See, sometimes they'll give the curved surface area. If they give it as curved surface area, then write only curved surface area. If they give it as given surface, then take the total surface area. So s is equal to
should be 2 pi r h.
Oh, sorry, yeah. Plus 2 pi r square. Yeah. This is fixed. Okay. Volume is equal to what? Pi r square h. So volume is a function of r and h. Correct?
Yes.
So what we will do is we will write h in terms of r from 1. From 1, I can write h is equal to s minus 2 pi r square divided by 2 pi r. So take it and substitute it in the volume. Pi r square into s minus 2 pi r square divided by 2 pi r. So pi and pi will get cancelled. R and r will get cancelled. R is minus 2 pi r cube, the whole divided by 2 is volume. Now can you differentiate? dv by dr is equal to what? S minus 6 pi r square divided by 2 is equal to 0. So s is how much? S is 6 pi r square. Let this be 2. So I will take 2 and substitute it in 1. So 6 pi r square is equal to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. Correct, Adam? So 4 pi r square is equal to 2 pi r h. 2 pi and this will get cancelled, r and r. So h is equal to 2 r. So that is what they told. No, you need to prove that the cylinder will have maximum volume if the height is equal to the diameter of the base. H is equal to 2 r. 2 r is the diameter of the base.
Okay, I understood.
Got it? So this is how you solve problems, guys. So we'll stop with this. We'll see the remaining problems in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.